This brings us to our second topic, producing EMF, or voltage. There are six primary sources of EMF, or electrical energy, including magnetic energy, chemical energy, the energy of friction, light, mechanical pressure, and heat-produced EMF. Let's see how each of these primary energy sources can be used to produce an electrical difference in potential. Magnetism is the most common method for producing electricity and electrical power, and provides more electrical power than all other sources combined. The very important relationships between electricity and magnetism will be covered in detail in a later lesson. At this time, let's discuss only the basic principle that allows magnetism to produce an EMF. When a magnetic field passes through a conductor, free electrons are moved toward one end of the conductor. This causes a difference in potential, or EMF, between the ends of the conductor. As the wire moves back and forth, the electrons are pushed alternately one way and then the other by the magnetic field. This causes the voltage to alternate in polarity. An alternating current, or AC, would flow in a circuit connected to such an alternating voltage. Note that the electrons do not move if the wire is just held still near the magnet. They stay distributed across the wire. Thus, it is the movement between the magnetic field and the conductor that produces current, not just the magnet itself. It is this phenomenon of magnetism that is the principle of the electric generator, a very common source of electrical energy. Here are two schematic symbols used to represent a generator. Movement between the wires and magnetic fields inside a generator produces the electric power. A generator may be hand-cranked, but most are powered by steam turbines, water power, or even wind power. No matter how the generator is driven, the electric current leaves the power station, travels over miles of power lines to reach your home, and provide the necessary voltage at the outlets to power the appliances you use. Most generators produce AC voltage. The voltage regularly reverses polarity, pushing the current back and forth. In a car, the generator, called an alternator, has its voltage changed to DC to recharge the battery. Batteries, such as this automobile battery, produce DC. Batteries are a common example of a chemical energy source. Chemicals are the most common source of portable electrical power. Besides a car battery, the cells inside this flashlight are another common source of chemically produced EMF. Once again, chemical energy produces DC voltage. Let's take a closer look at how a cell operates. All cells contain two different terminals, or electrodes, immersed in a chemical solution called an electrolyte. The electrolyte is either a paste or a liquid. This cell contains electrodes that are immersed in a paste and is called a dry cell. The automobile battery uses a liquid electrolyte solution and is called a wet cell battery. This wet cell works on the same principle as an automobile battery. The electrolyte, in this case dilute sulfuric acid, draws electrons away from the copper electrode, causing it to become positively charged. The other electrode, made from zinc for this cell, gives up positive ions to the electrolyte, causing the zinc electrode to become negatively charged. The net result is that electrons are pulled from the positively charged plate to the negatively charged plate. If a load is connected between the two terminals, the electrons will flow from the negative electrode and will be attracted to the positive electrode. Once they reach the positive electrode, the electrons are chemically drawn from it back to the negative electrode by the electrolyte.